यस अभिनंदन, वी शुड स्टार्ट। हेलो अभिनंदन, सर। हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। टुडे इज द सेकेंड क्लास ऑफ JMC 6, विच इज पीयर एडवर्टाइजिंग एंड मीडिया मैनेजमेंट। एंड वी डू हैव आवर रिसोर्स पर्सन मिस्टर बिबुदत्त महापत्र, डॉक्टर बिबुदत्त महापत्र सर। ही इज द मैनेजर एट आदित्य बिरला एज डीलिंग विद कॉर्पोरेट एंड पीआर। So, sir is also our counselor at BJP College, BJP Study Center. And last time we have gone through one class, that is purely advertisement. So, we hope most of you people have joined in that class. And today is the second class. And we welcome Bibhudatta sir to this session. I would also like to introduce our technical team, Avinandan, as well as Sumita Maharana, those who are looking up the technical aspect, allowing the student to join in this session, as well as my co-colleague, Mr. Rakesh Das is there also. And so let us start the class now. Sir, Bibhu sir.
Yes, thank you, Bishop. Good afternoon, everyone.
Over to you now, sir.
Yeah. Thank you very much. A very good afternoon to all of you, and hope all of you are taking care of yourself and safe at home. Me too also. So let us just I want to have a quick wrap up of what we had discussed in my last class regarding advertisement, and it would be beneficial for those who are not present. So just to wrap up in a 1 minute, we have discussed the nitty-gritty of advertisement. Exactly what is advertisement, its definition, its types, its classifications, how or why advertisement is required, and how advertisement works as a tool for PR, and so many things. Today we'll be discussing about, I'll be concentrating on public relations, and as in my last class also I had given you an idea that we'll be discussing one by one. Like this class will be discussing, concentrating upon public relations and its tools, its what are the publics in PR, and its strategies, and what are the, you can say, the different mechanisms whereby what in fact, first of all, the objectives, the need for PR, the objective of PR, the PR functions, PR tools, PR strategies, how a PR campaign is made, why it is made, what is the objective behind that, and also if time permits, crisis communication, corporate communication, and CSR. I think that will take another one class. So let us take it how it goes, because you know that because of the paucity of time, I would not be able to touch. I'll try to touch the maximum points, but whatever would be left out, you can also raise after my deliberation is over. And that during that question answer session. So to start with, I think I have discussed the definition of public relations in my last class, that is the British Institute of Public Relations. There is a much famous definition which in fact contains everything, which says that the public relation is the deliberate, planned and sustained effort to establish and maintain the mutual understanding between an organization and its publics. You know, you just see that each word of this definition, in fact, relates to PR. It is a deliberate. I have already told that PR is always done with keeping an objective in mind. It is always intentional. It is always deliberate. That means you want to achieve something through your PR. So it is your objective. It is your deliberate and conscious objective that you want to achieve that. Then to achieve that, to achieve not only your, in fact, individual goal, but also organizational goal, you need to have a conscious process, which is called a plan, which involves a planning, and again sustain. That means, you know, it is a continuous process. It is never haphazard. It is never time bound. It is always a continuous, and you can sustain effort. And the objective is to establish a mutual relationship between an organization and its publics for the achievement of the objective. In fact, every organization, every even an individual also, you see, the PR is required for each and every people, not only for the professional, but also at family also, you need to have good PR with your peers, with your kins, with your kith and kins. Unless until you have that PR, you cannot, you can say, achieve not only your individual, but also your collective goal. So public lesson as the definition, and in fact, that is a bookish definition. The practical definition is, because of my own experience, I will be telling you from last two decades of working in PR and communication sector, I must tell you that public relation has to be always a positive relation. It is not public relation. It is always public positive relation. And to have that positive relations, you need to have personal relations. Unless until you have that sort of personal bonding with your stakeholders or with whom you interact, or with your, we can say, in the PR language, it is called target groups. Unless you have that personal bonding, that personal emotional, that attachment, you cannot have that positive relations. And you know, always PR is understood in a positive manner. If suppose you are representing an the PR of your organization, or you are doing something which will be related to the goal of your organization, and you are a failure in that, then definitely your boss or your seniors will tell you that you are an absolute failure in your keeping public relations. So keeping from this point of view, and keeping all those in mind, one must say that public relation has to be always positive. And unless until that personal relationship or personal rapport has been established, that positivity cannot be achieved in public relations. So always take public relation not for the sake of this, you can say, term, but you can take it as a positive relations and personal relations. Then coming to, I'll not go into that other definitions, because most of these definitions are related with this only. So the simple definition is to keep positive relations, to keep personal relationship between an organization and its publics. Again, the word comes publics in public relations. We have to discuss that. Who are the publics in public relations? That means it will vary from organization to organization, and from, in fact, say sector to sector. Suppose, but broadly, this can be categorized into two types. One is internal and another is external. The internal public mainly consists of its own employees, its own staff. It's you can say the persons who have got direct interest in that organization goal, and also the, you can say, the investors, the persons who have invested in that particular company or particular organization, and who also get to know about what has been, you can say, what has been for them from the company. That's why they can be called as internal public. And besides this internal public, whosoever come into direct or indirect contact with the organization, for whose relationship is, for the relationship of whom is very much essential for the growth of that particular organization, they are called the external publics. So they may be the external publics. In fact, if you will count, they will be larger in number, depending upon organization to organization. First is, you can say, if it is a, I'll tell you the difference between B2B and B2C company. Most of you must be knowing about the B2B and B2C. B2B is business to business, and B2C is business to consumer. So why I'm telling you this classification of this company is because for this, the public will vary. You know, for an organization, the first public is its customer, or for the, in fact, say the main target group is the customer for whom the product of a company is being made. So coming to this B2B and B2C, I think most of you must be knowing that. Just let to for to clarify your, in fact, to make you more comfortable in explaining this classification of these publics. B2B is business to business. That means the companies who are directly dealing with each other from business to business. I'm giving an example of this by I'm giving a suitable example of this to explain this difference. Take the case of our company, Aditya Birla Group. It deals with, you must be knowing about, it deals with metal, mining, and also retail, and also different products which directly goes to the customers. Like I'm giving this example, this Hindalco. This Hindalco is a metal aluminium manufacturing company of Aditya Birla Group. The product which this Hindalco is producing, like the aluminium metal, the ingot, the rods, don't think that they are directly going to the common man, because it will be of no use for the common man. So what the common man use from the out of the product of the aluminium? This aluminium utensils, this you can say the aluminium being used in the vehicles, aluminium being used in the aeroplanes. So we don't directly, that Hindalco as a company don't give its aluminium ingot to the in fact say the people who are using the aeroplane, or the people who are using the utensils or any aluminium made product. So we give that to another company who adds value to that and make a product which are being usable by the common man. So in this case, this dual chain of operation happens. That means from business to another business company, and then that business company's product to directly consumer. Even our, like I'll give another example of which will be more clear about B2C, like our telecom product, the Idea. This our Idea SIM directly goes to the customer. That is B2C. Our own garment manufacturing, Allen Solly, you can say Louis Phillips and Peter England, that directly goes to the people. That is a B2C product. So I think this aluminium and this apparel differences, like that means the aluminium and this fabric and this apparel making products, explanations would be sufficient enough to explain you about this B2B and B2C company. So particularly depending upon this nature of business, this publics also varies for the public relations practitioners. So coming to this, before going to the publics also, just let me tell you about the why we need PR. You know, the first basic function, there may be several aspects of PR, but the core function of PR is to three things: create, maintain, and enhance the image of a company. I have used three words: creates, creation of image. So suppose about the product, nobody knows about exactly what it is, what it deals with, what exactly the company's, you can say, the brand name or the whatever. The new company, for a new company, the role of PR is to create an image whereby it achieves its objective in the, you can say, in the minds of the customers. Or you can, sorry, customer will be wrong one, the stakeholders. Then another second says, if the image is being already created, then it has to be maintained. Like I have told you, the PR is a continuous, or you can say, sustained process. So it has to be maintained, and not only maintained, it has to be enhanced, it has to be taken forward. It has to be taken to a greater heights, so that this image of that company keeps on increasing with each passing day, and its image is being intact. So the first, the main role of the PR public relation is to create, maintain, and enhance the public image of a company. As I have already told you that PR is required for every professional. Even so, take the case of journalist. You must be thinking that why PR is required for a journalist? Yes, journalist PR is required for a journalist very much, because internally as well as externally, if the journalist will not be having good PR public relationship with his fellow journalist, suppose one journalist falls sick. And because of his illness, he could not be able to go to the spot and gather the information for the story which he has to file. Even in this, you can say this, take this present COVID-19 crisis. Most of the people, you must have interacted also with the journalist. And if some of the journalist friends are there here in this platform, they must be also knowing if they have not, for due to some other reason, they could not be able to go to that particular spot and they couldn't gather the required information. In that case, what they do? They do either they call their friends, or in fact, I have also seen that in many cases, even in electronic media also, they transfer their visuals. Because ultimately, the objective is to file the story, the common story. It will not happen in case of exclusive, but in common happenings, it happens. So if you have that good PR skill with your fellow journalist, then naturally you would be able to, manage over your not being there. Even while from sitting at home also, you can just file the story by just making some few calls. So Josh, I've given an example. So PR is required for every professional, and also an organization also requires PR, public relation, for establishing its name, establishing its image in the minds of the people, or in the minds of its stakeholders, concerned stakeholders, or you can say target groups would be the right word. So there are different situations which may require for PR. One is promotion. You know, I've already told you that to enhance the image of the company, or to promote the image of the company, to promote the products of the company, you need to require public relations. Like suppose one company will be coming up with one new product. So what is that product? What is exactly that deals with? And what is, I have already explained in last class, that through advertisement also it can be done. But advertisement is one of the tool for public relations. It is not exactly the same as the public relations. Advertisement is a tool. But public relations is a broad activity which includes advertisement as a tool. But besides that, public relations has its many aspects we'll discuss. So for promotion, PR is required. Then to deal with controversy, to deal with any crisis, to deal with any, you can say, resistance, you need to have good PR. How? Suppose in an organization, the crisis can be of two types. One is internal and another is external. The internal may arise because of, due to lack of proper working conditions. Lack of proper salary. Okay, and then because of not having healthy working conditions. The organization is not following any proper employee welfare activities, the resistance maybe could be there internally. So in those cases, PR is required to manage over that crisis, that internal crisis. But more than that, the crisis that happens very often is in external sphere, which is called the real crisis management. Like maybe because of that crisis, I'll deal with that in a separate class. But crisis, for managing that crisis, you need to have good PR. And remember always, the PR people are always there to manage over a crisis. Like, you know, suppose any internal or external crisis happens in an organization, it is the public relations people, it is the public relations head or the PR concerned PR person who first comes into picture. He acts as a linchpin between the organization and its concerned public. Why I mentioned this concerned public? If it is an internal, this is internal crisis, then it is internal public. And if it is outside external crisis, then the external publics are the source where he acts the linchpin. Then third is, besides managing the crisis and you can say promoting the product, to maintain the image, you can say, you know, every good company, every good company always pays attention that its image is being maintained in the minds of its public. So these are you can say situations which call for public relation. And mostly public relation, as I have already told you, that it is a way of establishing positive relationship through personal rapport, through personal bonding with your concerned stakeholders, be it internal or external. Some question may arise in your mind that why internal PR is also required? Because I'll be dealing with these internal PR tools like these preparation of news, house journals, newsletters. You know, that internal PR has to be there. That has to be established at any cost. Otherwise, you will not get any information, any material, any sort of, you can say, stuff which will help you to prepare your internal communication tools. I'll come to that in detail. So PR is also a process, you know. What is called a process? Process is like you are doing an activity in an orderly manner. That means what should come after what. If you are following the right strategy, if you are following the right flow of activities in an orderly manner, then it is called a process. So PR is also a process. For doing a PR activity or PR campaign, what is required is that that PR campaign, again, it needs, so I'll discuss with you in detail when I come to that stages. But for your understanding how PR is a process, you need to understand what is exactly PR activity or PR campaign. In fact, if you have an objective, deliberate objective of promoting one, you can say, campaign for a social cause or for launching your new product, you need to first analyze where your company stands at present. For that, you have to do a lot of research in terms of, you can say, by doing a survey, by doing a benchmark analysis of your company's product, similar product with that of others, by means of a third party survey, or by means of, you can say, an independent survey which you can conduct. That is called the research activity, or you can say the research listening, or you can say that whatever outcome would be that of that research process, then you have to be avoided with that. Suppose you come to the conclusion, you have gathered some information that nobody knows about your name or brand name, then in that case, what you have to do? You have to start from the scratch. You have to start from that image creation level. Then suppose again you have come to one conclusion, or you have got a feedback that your stakeholders know your brand. Then what needs to be done further? Accordingly, you will plan it. Which medium will select to propagate your message? Which medium? Again, in the selection of the medium, the viability of its the viability of access factors. That means how many of your audience have got this access to which type of mediums. That also you need to analyze. And after getting into all those things, then you have to frame a campaign or a PR activity. That's why I called it as a process. And not only that, while executing that also, you need to ensure that it is being ensured in proper right manner. And after that, you have to analyze, review, evaluate where you stand, or at the end of the day, what is your final outcome, whether you have achieved your purpose or any lacuna is there. what could have been done to do it much better? That factor needs to be you can say properly informed to you by doing all these process activities. So PR is a process. And then coming to tools, oral communication is a very good and effective tool. You know, suppose whatever can't be achieved in terms of writing mails, writing letters, that can be achieved by one-to-one discussion or by sitting across the table. You know, if, I have realized that in many cases, in my cases, I never believe in writing any letter or any such communication to any person or any stakeholder who is having a different opinion about me or my, not only me, my organization. I always go to that person, sit in front and try to first understand that what exactly he or the other stakeholder wants or is having the impression about. Then, depending upon this, my strategy of oral communication is being framed. You know, there are, when I'll be discussing the qualities of the PR, the first qualities of the PR for people is to keep eyes and ears open and shut your mouth. Not exactly shut your mouth, but whenever it is required, tell. Don't, you can say, tell for the sake of telling. So always you have to keep your eyes and ears open. So in coming to this oral communication, when you'll be having that one stakeholder is having your, you are having a difference of opinion, or you can say both of you differ from in your own ideology, or in fact in case of not only your personal ideology, not a case of personal ideology, it is case of propagating your organizational ideology. Then in that case, you have to clear that misconception through oral communication. And oral communication happens not only sitting across the table also, like over phone also, you can have that communication. That means speaking. That means whenever you are using this speaking mode of communication, you are using this tool. Then a major tool of public relation is, I have forgotten to tell you one thing. While making difference from public relation from that of advertisement, corporate communication, and another activity is there, CSR, I must tell you that PR is a broad activity which includes all these combined together. In fact, advertisement can be categorized under PR. Corporate communication can be categorized under PR. Media relations, CSR activities can be categorized under PR. But the basic difference here is that public relation strategically is a, in fact, it's a broad activity. But when it comes to function, for each and every activity, you need to have that PR as a tool. That means functionally PR, public relation is an art. It's an activity which acts as a tool for all these ancillary activities. Like I'm giving the example, sorry, advertisement. Suppose you are directly, without taking the help of an advertisement agency, you are releasing an advertisement on behalf of your company. But you are seeing that if you take into account the different tariff rate of all these newspapers, it is surpassing your budget. So in that case, what you have to do, you have to request them. You have to, you can say, politely say them, you have to influence them, you have to persuade them so that they can take your advertisement in a very reduced rate, or in a very, you can say, mutually agreed upon negotiated rate. For that, you need to have good PR. Here you are exercising your PR art or PR skill. Similar is the case in corporate communication. Similar is the case in media relation. Suppose you have got a very good media relationship with all the journalists. There is no need to give advertisement. No doubt, advertisement is essential. But here, if you are you have strong media relations, that advertising budget would be reduced. No newspaper can bargain you and to publish your newspaper with that of publication of an advertisement. I agree wholly with this concept that advertisement is a must for running the newspaper. It adds to their revenue. But besides that, if you have good PR, if you have good rapport with these your stakeholders, then your job can be achieved in a in a lesser amount. That's why the organizations require the professional PR people to be in place. Then coming to the tools, let us discuss first about the categories wise. Let us first discuss the external PR tools. External PR tools, first of all, media relation will come. You know media relations, relationship with the media, in if we will reverse the word. Why we need, why organization need media for their, you can say, public relations? Because it is the media through which you can propagate, you can inform about you and your product to the rest of the world. So media here acts as a linchpin between you and the organization. And coming to this media relations, there is no, whatever I'll be telling you, there is no bookish definition of, or differentiation of that. But out of my experiences, out of my professional experiences, I have categorized media relationship into three categories. One is proactive media relation, proactive, PRO hyphen active relations, media relations. Second is reactive media relations. And third is interactive media relations. You know, in coming to one by one, proactive, whenever this pro word is there, it means that you are doing something proactively or before something, before someone asks to do use that. That is called proactiveness. So here, when you come to proactive media relations, it means that you are proactively, you are spontaneously, you are, I can say, from your own side, you are maintaining relationship with the media, whereby your organization goal is achieved. There are different occasions where proactive media relations is being maintained. Suppose you know, the media is always behind the stories. And as a PR professional, if you will give them the lead for that story, then the media would be happy to pick up that. And it depends upon the nature of the story, whether it will be an exclusive story or whether it will be a general story. But this activity is an example of proactive media relations, like giving a press release, giving an idea to the journalist about what they want. That means if before they want, if you give them, that is called proactive. Another example is that, suppose on a particular crisis, on a particular crisis, before the media asks you for any information, if you proactively give them, then you know it at many times ease the crisis to many extent. That means it reduces the crisis. So that is called proactive media relations, when you are interacting with the media from your own side and doing their job on their behalf. And I have told you, releasing a press release, or you can say press conferences, press briefings. I think here I must tell you one thing. Most of you must be having any confusion regarding press release, press briefing, and press conference. So let me just tell you in two to three minutes, what is the basic difference in that. You know, press release is, you know, as the definition itself implies, it is a release made for the press. That means the release has to be made by whom? By the organization's PR department, or by this organization's spokesperson, or the organization's communication head. So it has to be always in a written form. So press release is a release being written in being written by the concerned corporate communication or the PR department head which is meant for the media person, informing about, suppose that about will have two, three bullet points about the, you can say, information about the product, new product, information about, you can say, a promotion of a company, from promotion of a particular product, and third is informing about clearing the misconceptions if you are having any relating to any crisis. So press release can be issued in these different cases. So issuance of press release, and another thing, you just keep it in mind that press release is always signed by the concerned person with his letterhead and seal. If it is in soft copy, then it has to go from the concerned person's official email ID. Then it can be considered as a press release. Then coming to press conference, you know, like a conference for the press. When it comes to the word conference, you are becoming a bit more formal. So it is a formal conference. That means for this, you need to plan it much before. You need to plan it, you can say, keeping different small things in view, like how the journalist will come, how or where they will see it, what they will write, how they will write. So all these things you have to plan. You have to plan it accordingly so that any stone is not remain unturned. And any failure in the press conference will amount to, you can say, the harnessing the image of the company. So you have to be very, very careful about this. So this press conference is also a tool of proactive media relations. Then in a press conference, question answer session is a must. So that is the basic difference from press briefing, from that of press conference, from that of press briefing. So in a press conference, a schedule is being fixed to organize that question answer session where the journalists are advised to ask questions relating to that particular event or the very purpose for which this conference is being made. So, but which is, again, coming to press briefing. Press briefing is, you can say, at times, whenever it is required, that the media needs to be briefed at a very short interval about a particular, you can say, information, just for the sake of giving any important information by any company, any government, whosoever. What they do, the concerned PR department only call the limited or the selective, largely circulated newspaper and channels, and they give the briefing. And hardly any one or two questions may be taken for that. You know what what daily at 4:30 Mr. Bakshi is doing, that is press briefing, media briefing. That is not conference. Mind it, it is not conference. It is only media briefing. And also, to add to this, a press release can be issued. Press release is a must for press conference, because you know, as I have mentioned, that you have to take care, you have to be very, very careful about each and every aspect of this conference, like how the journalists will come, who are coming, how they will come, where they will sit, how they will write, that preparation of that press kit. In a press kit, it contains the press release. The press release is a must. And you and a writing pad and a pencil or a pen or any any such thing which your organization, in which your organization's you can say brand name is being, you can say, placed, or your by giving such thing your brand name is established or getting a promotion, that you can give. So, like, you can give a pen by the branding of your company's name in that, like this pen, whatever I'm showing you. This is an UltraTech pen, where the company's name is being printed or it is being ingrained in that. So this is, you can say, this is about press kit. I'll not go into other details of the press kit, which, you know, nowadays there are so many questions, so many discussions, so many controversial discussion on that press kit, on that content of that press kit. beside this, you can say many of time the journalists are also interested in not in being journalists are interested more in what is being kept in the press kit, not this press release or this pen or pad. Anyway, that's a separate matter, and for that we need to discuss informally. So coming to this media relations, I have told you that's proactive media relations. Like I have told you, this press release, this idea, giving the idea of one lead of a story to media, and interacting with the media on a daily, day-to-day basis from your own side, that is called proactive media relations. Then coming to reactive media relations, as the name itself implies, you know, whenever you feel as a corporate communication or a PR professional that something has come out in media, be it print or be it electronic, without your notice or without you being not informed. So in that case, media reactive media relations happen. What you will do? Suppose one wrong information about your organization has come in the media on a particular day, and you came to know when at a time when it has already come. In that case, what you have to do, you need to give a rejoinder, or you need to give a, I can say, a corrigendum, which may be published in the same newspaper. Or if that journalist or the reporter of that same newspaper is being has you can say become so much annoyed upon you that that publication will not carry your corrigendum or your point of view, in that case you can do it in a similar competitive newspaper. Suppose if your negative news has come in Indian Express, you can always try for Times of India. If it has come in Sambad, then you can always try for Samaj. So that what is the purpose of having this reactive media analysis? Suppose your point of view, your organization point of view is cleared in the minds of the readers if they do have any wrong information. And third is I am telling you the reactive media relations, interactive media relations, where you come to interact with the media people on a day-to-day basis from your own side, as well as they also come to you, because you know for them you are a source of news. They depend upon you for not only for news but also for other, like advertisements and getting information about the lead stories. So these are all, you can say, this is a way of, we can say, two-way process where this interactive media relationship occur. Then coming to other tools, you know, outdoor hoardings and you can say outdoor hoardings, display of hoardings, display of banners at different places about your messages. You know, there the company always try to reach out to its external stakeholders in this mode. So display of hoardings, outdoor hoardings, billboards, and all these things act as a tool for public external public relations, where you have to here smart thing is that you need to know about these vantage locations. Vantage location means the POS localities in a particular city or in a particular place, whereby you can place your message accordingly by in terms of hoardings or banners or display boards or billboards. Okay, then coming to another tool of media relations, which is called community relations. You know, community relations or the you can say the relationship with the common the people where your organization's business is located, like your plant is located, or your you can say your area of operation is comes under that periphery, that village periphery. So you need to keep good relationship with the community where you are based or where you stay. In that case, you know, there is a concept called CSR that comes into being. That means corporate social responsibility. This means what the company should do for the society or for the people. This in a broad sense, I'm telling you this. In detail, I will talk with, on this in a later class. So this community relations not only gets achieved through CSR, but also through persuading the common man to take your product, to accept your service by means of interacting with them directly, by means of reaching out to them through their opinion leaders. Here I have used one term, opinion leaders. You know, opinion leaders are the persons who are the veterans in their respective areas and respective locations. I've again used two words, who are veterans in their respective areas and respective locations. Areas means here not location. Areas in their area of study, their area of activity. Suppose the journalist, the senior journalist or the columnist or the retired bureaucrats, the retired IPS officer, IS officers, the retired bureaucrats, the veteran politicians, those voices which matters in the society in shaping the public opinion, they are called the opinion makers. So you have to take care of the opinion makers, because if naturally the PR people will always say good things about their organization, but if any opinion maker will say in terms of writing one column in about you in a particular newspaper, or by publicly speaking, or by directly speaking with the community or your stakeholders about your positive things, then that matters a lot. In community, that's why in I have told you about this opinion maker's role in these metropolitan cities, or you can say for the intellectual masses. But for the illiterate villagers or for the people of the villages, how do you touch them? You will touch them through their, you can say, the school headmasters, the school teachers, the school Anganwadi workers, because for them, they are the opinion makers. If you will say, they will not obey. But if you will take the help of them, the school headmaster and your school headmaster will tell the good things about your company's product and your company's, you can say, CSR activities, then they will take it with, you can say, much respect. But they can't do that while remaining in their job. A retired headmaster is always an opinion maker, which can prove a very, which can act as a very, you can say, effective linchpin between you and your stakeholders. So coming to again, another tool is that news. I'll come to the internal tool. Then the one external tool is called social media. You know, social media, which has become the very buzzword of each and everybody's area of operation. Whatsoever for which things can't be told or can't be published in a newspaper or a channel, you can place it in social media. You are free to say anything in social media, because there is absolute freedom and absolute space available to post anything of any capacity, be it a 1 hour video or be it a 1000 words story. So social media is, you can say, has become a very effective tool. And why it is not only that, everybody is in social media, and everyone is now taking the help of the social media. So it is a very effective tool to shape or influence or persuade the people or the stakeholders, because PR is all about, you know, persuasion, influencing, persuading, and you can say promoting. Finally, the objective is to achieve the goal of your organization. So this is also another tool. Then coming to the internal tools. In internal tools, the first is called internet portal. You know, there is a difference between internet and intranet. Intranet is communicating within the circle. So every company is having its own internet portal to get connected with all its employees, all its internal public across the globe, who are staying across the globe in different locations. You know, this COVID-19 measures have given us an opportunity to work from home. And this, due to this internet communication facilities, we are working in like we are working at home. Yes, sorry, working at office. There is no difference. Whatever we are supposed to do by sitting at the office, we are doing it here. By sitting at home, and it is happening only because of this, you can say, internet portals or getting connected with each other. Whosoever sitting at New York or whosoever sitting at Bhubaneswar. So it is about internet. First is the internet web portal, and also internet portal also connect you to not only to do such type of conferences or meetings or one-to-one discussions, but also it contains the details about these employees, each and every employee's information, its establishments in a very we can say visible manner, where the employees can also not only chat but also share their own personal, you can say, informal discussions. That also happens in internet portal. And second is house journal. You know, house journal is a journal, as the name itself implies. It is meant for the house only, in house circulation only. That means I was just the next day I was discussing with my colleague at Utkal Alumni that how to prepare our new house journal and what should be the content. You know, in a house journal, first of all, while designing anything, any product, you need to analyze who would be your takers or who would be your target audiences. There, you have, suppose in house journal, your only internal customers or stakeholders would be your takers. So in that case, what you have to do, you have to produce such information, you have to give such informations in a very lucid and well-designed, well-articulated format so that they like it. And house journal comes in a hard copy. There are also many organizations who prefer to release it in soft copy, but mostly the how to make it more, you can say, attractive, to make it more handy, to make it more, to have that, you can say, that concept of possessiveness, they're bringing it in hard copies. So that house journal's content would be only the things and the information related to the companies and their employees. Like, what milestone the company has achieved, any product of the company is, whether it is being introduced to the common, you can say, public, and what are these profit of the company in last quarter, so that the stakeholders also, the external stakeholders, the internal stakeholders, the board of directors or the investors can have an idea of that. Then coming to, suppose one of your employees son or daughter is very good in creativity, or he or she has achieved a very spectacular performance in his academics or any extracurricular activities, you need to give those information in that house journal. So the objective is to keep the entire internal stakeholders intact on a single thread. That is the very objective of a house journal, which acts as a very effective tool of internal peer communication. Then coming to this is about the tools of internal and peer communication. And next is, you can say, you know, what are the benefits of peer? When peer is always achieves, you can say, at a peer is more credible. I'm giving you one example. How peer is more credible? Suppose about the good thing of your company, there are different ways to represent it. One is to give an advertisement. The easiest way is to inform the people, the reader, about by giving an advertisement either in print or electronic. If you have that money, you can have that much of space in print and that much of space in electronic media, and we can give your advertisement. But again, I'm telling you, the same thing can be achieved by media relations. If you have got good media relationship with the journalist, you can also, they will write positive things about your company or about your product. You think whichever is more credible, because everybody will say that are yaar uske paas paisa hai to anything or everything one can publish. But if it comes through a journalist by undergoing the process of filtering, by undergoing the series of gatekeepers, it comes in media, in whatever shape, and if it is in a good shape, then oh wow, everybody will say wow, because that is having more credibility. Getting a publicity through advertisement is possible by anyone who have that much of money, but getting this news published by means by I know, in fact, if some of you are in the PR professionals, they also know how difficult it is to convince the journalist to put forth your state of mind and to you can say to persuade them to carry your story. It's not a joke, and it can be achieved only through your, I have already told you in the beginning, the personal lessons and your positive lessons. So the PR is always at a very you can say it is always, it stands at a very you can say high point above, so far as credibility factor is concerned. And you know, it is also having less cost. You know, I have already explained to you, PR is always less costly. And third is image building. You know, from PR only you can build up your image. And another is, the thing is that an avoidance of clutter. If you would be having any confusion, if you would be having any misconception, any you can say a sort of disturbances, you can sort it out only through PR, which is, you can say, a must, a most effective tool of an organization. Then coming to corporate communication, I must tell you the difference, that the communication made by the corporate to reach out to its masses, are masses, both masses here includes both internal and public, external. So the communication designed by a corporate to reach out to its masses are called corporate communication. In fact, what we have discussed in PR tools, that can be also applied to corporate communication tools. Only the difference is here is that from corporate communication, from PR, is that again PR is a broad activity, corporate communication is becoming more and more specific. That means PR can include your corporate affairs liaising activities, PR can include your CSR activities, but corporate communication is only dealing with the communications which are being designed by the corporate for the masses. It can be internal, it can be external. And to get the job of the corporate communications done, the corporate communication professional must have the good PR skills. Here PR comes as a tool. So PR in broader sense, from strategical point of view, it's a broad activity, or all other activities can be called as a subset of this broad set, superset of PR. Whereas when it comes to function, when it comes to practical, every activity, all other activities need this PR as a tool. So I think with this, I must conclude today's deliberation, and I think you are free to ask me questions if you have any for the next 20 to 25 minutes. Biswabu, are you?
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So I think questions.
Thank you. I would like to request the students to put their question in the chat box, or else they can come and verbally ask the questions. It was a nice topic regarding public relation. It is the part of a journalism and mass communication field, where the students can pursue a career in this particular field, because most of the companies, they keep one of the wing like public relations. It is most essential in this segment, because organization directly and indirectly has to keep relationship with public, their own public as well as external public. Media, they keep always in the touch with media, because media is a platform which always communicate with the people or citizens. So definitely this wing is remain highlighted inside a corporate house, and corporate also look after how we can disseminate more and more information, how can we give support to the periphery as well as to our own people who are giving service to the organization. And several aspects are look after in between this department, advertisement, marketing, all are related to public relation, because whenever you go to the market, you first look after whether my product is having a rapport in the market or not. And advertising ultimately to run this whole world, or you can tell the media houses in a better way. So you have to support them. Not only that, giving our message throughout the media, and we will simply ask them to provide our content, but still we have to look after mutual relationship. This is a relationship between media and a corporate to giving advertisements. Thank you, sir, giving a complete lecture. It is an eye-opening lecture that I could feel that. And it is up to the student how they perceive it, and I hope they will go through the book for further reading, and they will grab more and more knowledge. So there is a question, sir. I think I should go through it. From Jita Dungdung, she is asking, in PR function, what is the objective of public relation? I think sir has discussed objective. So further, sir, you can yes, tell her in one or two.
I already told, but the objective is, you can say, suppose objective varies from organization to organization. If it is a you can say B2B or B2C company, the objective of the organization is to augment its sale, or there should be an increase in its sale figures. How the sale of that product is being increased, or what should be the strategy from PR point of view to augment its sale. So here the message should be designed accordingly, so that if it is for advertisement, how this advertisement artwork needs to be done, so that it can be more eye-catching and the customer should be compelled or interested to buy that product. And if it is for electronic media, take the case of a celebrity, take the help of a celebrity. If he or she will propound for your product, then it is also PR activities. Like objective varies from organization to organization. And objective, if it is for a crisis management, the same strategy which you are following for the augmenting of sales would not be applicable here. For crisis management, your objective is to manage the crisis. So your objective, accordingly, depending upon your objective, you need to strategize your PR activities accordingly. Manage the crisis. So different objectives. So I have already discussed that the two, three objectives brought the PR people work. For creation, for building of the image, enhancement and maintenance, and then if it is for a new product, how it will be promoted, and if it is for a crisis, how the crisis has to be. So these are broadly about this objective of this public relations, for which always the PR people work.
Yes, there is a suggestion from our my co-colleague Rakesh Kumar Das.
Can I say something,
he's
sir?
Telling that yes, Rakesh, if you have some idea, then
sir,
you can
Sir, thank you, sir. In my view, objectives of PR is very smart. That means SMART is SMART, smart, five words. That means S is for specific. Specific means state clearly what you want to achieve. M means measurable. Set tangible measures, so you can measure your result. A for A means achievable. Set objectives that are within your capacity and budget. R means relevant. Set objectives that will help you improve particular aspects of your business. T means time bound. That means set objectives you can achieve within the time you need to promote them. So according to me, PR objective is smart, sir.
Yes, very good. Very rightly said.
Yes, it has to, yes, it has right, to follow yes. That means whenever there is a need, then we should need we should do something on behalf of the public. Okay, so
sir,
we have to look up
the
smart
thing. One example, sir.
Yeah, tell me, speak out.
Yes,
sir. I want to explain an example in which you can find advertising, promotion, publicity, public relations, and your marketing and sales like thing. Just think, I'm telling it odia sir. ଧରିନିଅନ୍ତୁ ସାର୍ କାଲି ସୋମବାର ଦିନ ସନ୍ଧ୍ୟା 6:30 ବେଳେ ଭୁବନେଶ୍ୱରର ଜନତା ମଇଦାନ ପାର୍କରେ ଗୋଟେ ସର୍କସ୍ ହେବାକୁ ଯାଉଛି। ସେ ସର୍କସ୍ର କୌଣସି ଯଦି ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଜି କିମ୍ବା କାଲି ଠାରୁ ଯଦି ଜୟଦେବ ବିହାରର ଛକରେ ଲାଗୁଛି ତ ଆମେ ତାକୁ କହିବା ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ। କାହିଁକି ନା କୌଣସି ଗୋଟେ ଟେକ୍ସଟ କିମ୍ବା ସାଇନ୍ ଆମ ପାଇଁ ରଖାଯାଇଛି ଯୋଉଟାକି ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲେ ଜାଣୁଛେ ସେଇଟା ହେଲା ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ। ଯଦି ସର୍କସ୍ ମାଲିକ ସେଇ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ମାଟେରିଆଲକୁ କୌଣସି ଗୋଟେ ହାତୀ କିମ୍ବା ଘୋଡ଼ା ପିଠିରେ ହାତୀ ପିଠିରେ ଲଗେଇକି ସହର ସାରା ବୁଲଉଛି ଲୋକମାନେ ଦେଖୁଛନ୍ତି ତ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ପ୍ରମୋସନ। ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେଇ ହାତୀଟି ସହରରେ ବୁଲୁ ବୁଲୁ ଧରିନିଅନ୍ତୁ ମୁଖ୍ୟମନ୍ତ୍ରୀ କିମ୍ବା ମୁଖ୍ୟ ଶାସନ ସଚିବଙ୍କ ବାଡ଼ି ଭିତରେ ପଶି ତାଙ୍କ ଫୁଲ ଗଛ ଭାଙ୍ଗି ଦଉଛି ଆଉ ମେଡିଆ ତାକୁ କଭର କରୁଛି ଇନ୍ ଏ ହ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଆମାଉଣ୍ଟ ତ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ପବ୍ଲିସିଟି। ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲେ ଯେ ବାଡ଼ି ଭିତରେ ପଶିକି ବଗିଚା ଭିତରେ ପଶିକି ହାତୀ ଗଛ ଭାଙ୍ଗିଦେଲା କିନ୍ତୁ ଅଲ୍ଟିମେଟ୍ ପବ୍ଲିସିଟି ସର୍କସ୍ ମାଲିକ ହିଁ ପାଇଲା କାହିଁକି ନା ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲେ ଯେ ସର୍କସ୍ ହାତୀ ହିଁ ଭାଙ୍ଗିଦେଲା ଗଛ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ପବ୍ଲିସିଟି। ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେଇ ଜିନିଷକୁ ଚିଫ୍ ମିନିଷ୍ଟର କିମ୍ବା ଚିଫ୍ ସେକ୍ରେଟାରୀ ଦେଖିକି କୌଣସି ରିଆକ୍ସନ ଦଉଛନ୍ତି ହସି ଦଉଛନ୍ତି କିମ୍ବା ତା ବିଷୟରେ କୌଣସି ମନ୍ତବ୍ୟ ଦଉଛନ୍ତି ତ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ପବ୍ଲିକ ରିଲେସନ। କାହିଁକି ନା ଆମ ପ୍ରମୋସନର ଏମ୍ଟା ସକ୍ସେସ ହେଲା କି ଆମର ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଯିଏ ଅଛନ୍ତି ଯିଏ ଆମର ପବ୍ଲିକ ଅଛନ୍ତି କି ଆମ ବିଷୟରେ କିଛି ମତ ଦେଲେ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ପବ୍ଲିକ ରିଲେସନ। ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ସେଇ ହାତୀଟିକୁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନ ଅନୁସାରେ ବୁଲଉଛନ୍ତି ଧର ଆଜି ଶହୀଦନଗରରେ ବୁଲେଇବା କାଲି ସତ୍ୟନଗରରେ ବୁଲେଇବା ଏମିତି କିଛି ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନ କରିକି ବୁଲଉଛନ୍ତି ତ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ମାର୍କେଟିଂ। ଯେତେବେଳେ ସନ୍ଧ୍ୟା ସମୟ ଯେତେବେଳେ ସୋମବାର ସନ୍ଧ୍ୟାବେଳେ ଆମ ପାଖକୁ ଲୋକମାନେ ଆସିକି ପହଞ୍ଚୁଛନ୍ତି ଆମେ ତାଙ୍କୁ ଟିକେଟ୍ ସେଲ୍ କରୁଛୁ ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ହ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ସେଲିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଟିକେଟ୍ ଗ୍ୟାଦରିଂ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଲୋକମାନେ ସେ ଶୋଟାକୁ ବହୁତ ଏନ୍ଜୟ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ଦ୍ୟାଟ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ସେଲ୍ଫ ପ୍ରମୋସନ ସାର୍।
Okay, okay, Rakesh sir, thank you.
Thanks.
And there is a question from Snigdha Sri Balayar Singh. Example of intranet portal. She is asking about example of intranet portal, sir.
Regarding this, actually every company has its own portal. It is having a different name. Like in ours portal, it is called portal. And in there are also called web stream. There are different names, but unless until you go to particular company's internal portal, then you cannot be able to you can say that is you can say that is internet portal. And I think this I'm giving an example, not exactly it is like of internet portal, like WhatsApp groups you are making inside within yourself. Similarly, a platform is being created formally inside the internal stakeholders of a company. That is called internet. And unless until you particularly go to any company's internet portal, you can have that example in for it. But that that is different for different companies. That is different for different.
Yes,
companies.
Sir.
But this company.
Let me answer this one, sir.
Yeah.
In a big company, there are thousands of people, and to have a good communication in between those thousands of people, company right now cannot tell someone that you go to him and meet him and discuss and come. The portal has been created, means with the support of this internet, with the support of this computer, a connectivity is given to each and everyone to interlink. Means interlink means if you want to meet your boss, then you have to go to through his assistant, means his PA. You will tell, I want to meet the boss. Then he or she will be giving a permission. So you will first forward a letter to PA, then he will give a permission, then he will reply. In this regard, big companies have discussions. Means each and every department have discussions regarding each and every interlink aspect. Supposed to be it is a marketing, so the public relation will think if the marketing department is growing, then let us give a agenda to the marketing department. In this way the marketing department can prosper. If supposed to be advertising department, there is a time when the manager wants to give an advertisement, then he will inform to the public relation department. So the internet is a connectivity in between the organization to keep a relationship. So that is intranet. So whenever you are working, supposed to be, if you are not working in a company with maybe 10 people or being 100 or 1000 people, whatever may be the number, then you cannot able to understand what is the interrelationship between the organization people, means structural people, core people. Okay. Sir, another question is that PR is also a science.
Yes, it is very much a science, because, you know, as I have already told you in the definition, it's a very planned and deliberate and sustained effort. And PR involves it is a process also, because it what is a science? Science is being, you can say, it is being based upon certain principles, certain processes, and certain actions among different principles and processes. PR is like that. PR is a concrete process. If to do a campaign, you need to do a lot of activities before doing a campaign to get permission. You do a benchmark study. You allocate a budget. You finalize who would be your target groups. Then how you frame your PR strategy, and then execute, then evaluation. All these are process driven. So it's very much a science. The quality of public relation is an art. The relationship, or the developing the relationship, establishing the personal rapport, establishing the personal rapport to get the positive relation, that. But whatever the processes, whatever the steps you are undergoing to achieve that, that involves science. So it is both an art and a science.
Okay, thank you, sir. Another question is how to manage a crisis as PR?
So I think I have told you brief, but I need a separate class for crisis management and media management. But to answer your question, definitely PR people can only mitigate the crisis, because they are the people who understand the pulse of both the organization and where the crisis has happened, the other persons also. So they play a very balancing role in mitigating the, if it is an internal crisis, it is more, and if it is external crisis, it is also equally the responsibility of the PR people to deliver, to communicate such messages to outside, to clear all the misconceptions and manage the crisis. So that involves a different strategy and different entire gamut of activities. Okay, but it is the PR people who manage the crisis. They understand the pulses of both. So the organization and the affected people, or the affected stakeholders.
Sir, I want to add on something at here.
Yeah.
Presently, the situation throughout the world is in a crisis. You can tell each and every state is facing their crisis, how they will deal with different patients. The country also facing different crises of death scenarios and the number of COVID-19 patients. So here the public relation of the government is working in such a way that to give the relevant information to the media persons, and the media person will spread the same information. Before the crisis started, it was a planned way. The government thought that if we will give a right information to the media, then there will not be a vacuum of information in between the government as well as media. Because if you left out this public relation, then what would happen? The media person would have collected their own information of COVID patients. Or you can see in the social media, there are number of people tell, "Bhai, mo ghar pakhare bhi gote, patient bahar lani." So looking after all those information, the people would be in panic. Lokomane kon karthante gote bhoy bhita parivesh bhitre rahutante. Then ei jo situation ko handle kariya pai public relation aur health department aur government tini jan jagar milita sahajog re ebong anya department bi to ko bhole avare message jiba darkar. केते शॉर्ट रे मेसेज ता जीवा दरकार जे हमरो वर्तमान 17 जन लोक नुवा कोविड पेशेंट देखा गले बा सल्ला आ अधिक किछ कहिवार नै पण नेक्स्ट टू दैट हमरो एई क्राइसिस सिचुएशन को केमिते हैंडल करा होची वर्तमान एक भलो खबर मिलिछ जे 12 जन लोक भलो हे गले तापर पूर्ण 15 जन गोटे याडो नंबर ऑफ कोविड पेशेंट्स आर इंक्रीजिंग एंड अ पॉजिटिव न्यूज इज कमिंग दे पीपल आर नॉट डाइंग पीपल आर अल्टीमेटली rescuing from the disease, or you can tell they are reviving from the disease, or the patients are coming out of a proper health after recovered. So this is the crisis, and this is the crisis communication what is being prepared by the government.
So to add to you, Vishwa, another thing, every crisis, yes, three stages. That means it depends from crisis to crisis, but the crisis management is concerned, it involves three stages. That means pre-crisis, during crisis, and post-crisis. Suppose post-crisis. As a company professional, you are forcing any crisis to happen, okay? Because you know, suppose you, because of your lack of adequate other safety measures, something is going to happen. Beforehand, if something has happened and before the media asked you for something, if you are telling them proactively, naturally the amount of hostility will be released to some extent. Okay, that is pre. And again, that varies from case to case. And whatever you have nice during the crisis, that COVID-19 and post-crisis. So how the media is being properly communicated by the peer people of both the person of government and the health department. So not only government, but also in private sector, how the communication is being properly made during the crisis and after the crisis is over. What, like this case of LG Polymer case, you can say what should the next step of the that company in this backdrop? What other safety measures they are taking so that such type of instances will not happen in future? That the people should know, unless until they that sort of confidentiality or that sort of faithfulness is being established in the minds of the people, stakeholders, then the plant is not going to open. Take the case of example of this Sterlite plant at Tuticorin. That incident, you know, you must have heard about that firing incident. So after that crisis, again, the plant has been able to open within a span of 6 months. Now it is running. So what have they done? The very reason for which the crisis has happened, and it arose the wrath of the people. Now that misconception has already been cleared from their minds. That's even I was telling you that example of I don't think I've told you that example. Take the case of this Utkal Alumina plant and this Kalinganagar plant. Before the establishment of the plant, a lot of uproar and firing incident happened, in which five people died and in Kalinganagar 11 people died. But do you think that the project has stopped? Now they are running in their full strength, but it took some time. Then again, that managed that crisis to build that confidentiality in the minds of the people. The lot of CSR activities, lot of crisis management activities that need to be done, and they are being properly informed to the people. That's why we are in force, we are in place. Crisis management.
Mr. Ajay Kumar Raut is asking, what is he's asking two questions. Why media relation is important? Next is objectives of public relations.
Objectives of public relations, I think we have discussed. I think Rakesh has also said about smart and the broad four objectives which every PR department needs to work for. And about media relation, you know, media relation is a must, because media is a tool to propagate your rest of the people, to rest of your stakeholders. And media relations, unless until you have good media relations, then you will not be having any place in the minds of the people. Suppose I am giving an example, you are not having any media relations with the journalist. Journalist will suppose got some wrong information about your organization, then he hardly bothers about whether your by publication of any negative results, whether your company will be benefited or not benefited. So he will write on his own. He will not care for your organization stance or point of view. But if you are having good media relationship, then naturally he will pick up his mobile and make you a call to get his misconception clarified, if he has so any. So media relations is a must, and that is an effective tool of public relations and corporate communication professionals.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Another question is, how can a layman identify a paid news?
How can a layman identify paid news?
Paid news.
Sure.
I guess, sir.
So, to answer this, I must calm down to Odia. ମୋର ସାଙ୍ଗ ମାନେ ସବୁ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ନ୍ୟୁଜ ପେପର ରେ ସବୁ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ଆମେ ମୁଁ ଆମେ ଯେବେ ଜର୍ନାଲିଜିମ୍ ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିଥିଲୁ ଏବେ ସବୁ ନ୍ୟୁଜ ଏଡିଟର ଲେବଲ ହେଲାଣି କିଏ ସିନିୟର ନ୍ୟୁଜ ଏଡିଟର ହେଲାଣି ମୋତେ ଜଣେ ବନ୍ଧୁ ଦେଖା ହେଇଥିଲା ମୋ ସାଙ୍ଗ ମୁଁ ତାକୁ କଲାବେଳକୁ ମତେ ସେ କହିଲା ମୁଁ କହିଲା କିନ୍ତୁ ଭଲ ଅଛୁ ସେ ମତେ କହିଲା ଆରେ ଭଲ ଅଛି କଣ ଚାପିବା ଚାପିବାର ଚାପରେ ଚେପା ହେଇଯାଇଛି ଆଇ ଥିଙ୍କ ବୁଝିପାରୁଥିବେ ସମସ୍ତେ ମାନେ ଚାପିବା ଛାପିବା କୋଉ ନ୍ୟୁଜଟାକୁ ଚାପିବୁ ଆଉ କୋଉ ନ୍ୟୁଜଟାକୁ ଛାପିବୁ ସେଇଟା ସାମ୍ବାଦିକ ମାନେ ଚେପା ହେଇଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ସ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡୱିଚ୍ ହେଇଯାଉଛନ୍ତି ତ କହିବାର କଥା ହେଲା ତମେ ଯୋଉ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ ଜଣେ ପଚାରିଲେ ଯେ ହାଉ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ମାଇ ଡିଅର ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋ ସଚ୍ ମେକାନିଜମ୍ ଟୁ ମାନେ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଆଉଟ୍ ଦିସ୍ ରିଅଲ୍ ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଏଗେନ୍ ଡିପେଣ୍ଡ ଅପନ୍ ୟୁଅର ଏରିଆ ମାନେ ସିକ୍ସ ସେନ୍ସ ଦେଟ୍ ଗୋଟେ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପଢ଼ିଲା ପରେ ତମେ ଅତି ମାନେ ମାନେ ପ୍ରୋପାଗାଣ୍ଡା କଲା ଭଳିଆ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ହେଇଥିବ ଜାଣିବ ଯେ ଏଇଟା ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ହେଇଛି ବଟ୍ ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ର କିଛି ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ସେନ୍ସ ଅଛି ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ଅଛି ସେ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ଟା ବାହାରିଛି ତାହେଲେ ତମେ ଜାଣି ପାରିବନି କିନ୍ତୁ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ରେ କୌଣସି ପ୍ରକାର ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ନାହିଁ ଖାଲି ଜଷ୍ଟ ଗୋଟେ କମ୍ପାନୀକୁ ଆପିସ୍ କରିବାକୁ ବା କିଛି ଯଦି ଯେଉଁଟା କହୁଛ ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଫର୍ମାଟ୍ରେ ଗୋଟେ ସାମ୍ବାଦିକ ବାହାର କରୁଛି ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଦି ରିଡର୍ ଆଜ୍ ଦି ବେଷ୍ଟ ଜଜେସ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଦି ପର୍ସନ୍ ହୁ ରିଡ୍ସ ଦି ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ହି ଇଜ୍ ଦି ବେଷ୍ଟ ଜଜ୍ ଟୁ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏ ହେଦର୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଅର୍ ଅନ୍ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଅନ୍ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପିଆର୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ଆମକୁ କହୁ ଅନ୍ପେଡ୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ନୁହଁ ପିଆର୍ ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ସେଇଟା
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Next is how can a layman? What is the role of PR in social? What is the role of social media in PR?
Role discussing this social media because of its wide visibility, wide reach. In fact, its scope for to carry. N number of articles, N number of space, videos. So it has become a very easy platform for the PR professionals to propagate views. So social and another factor is that nowadays it is the age of digital media and social media. So every now and then every person is having each of you having a smartphone. Either you will go to Facebook or Twitter or you can say other Instagrams, so social media platforms. So naturally, social media has become a very important platform for the PR people to propagate their views.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Another thing is that because of the lack of gatekeepers or the lack of filtering in social media, also you can put anything which you want.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
As PR activities concerned, like I think this was describing about that incident, that circus party and that elephant carrying the banners of that circus party. If it can be the entire gamut of activity, if it can be put in social media, it will be also impactful. What others could say, the people through social media, they could be able to see that. So that's social media is a very vibrant media right now.
Okay, sir. So we'll take this one question, last question. CSR is meant for local development or for Prime Minister Relief Fund? I think he has not gone through properly.
I'll tell you this CSR part. I was telling you I will be taking another class on CSR and crisis management and media management. But to answer to this question, CSR is actually the as the nomenclature itself implies, it is called the corporate social responsibility. Earlier, what was happening, it is true for all times to come, whenever any organization or any company gets any benefit from the people of a particular region, it has the moral responsibility to give something back to the society, which is called the corporate social responsibility of the corporate towards society. So coming to this question, what he has said, please come again. It is not Prime Minister's. I'm just forgetting. CSR is meant for
Prime Minister Relief Fund.
No, it is not for Prime Minister Relief Fund. It is for local development. And again, in the time of this international global pandemic, if you are contributing something to the PM Relief Fund, which is taking care of the people directly, so it is also called CSR. Here it can be called CSR. And in terms of contributing to the CMRF. Chief Minister Relief Fund or Prime Minister Relief Fund, it is also called CSR, but at different given situations, at different, like in last funny, to the CM relief fund, we have contributed rupees 50 crore from our CSR fund. That is also CSR. In here, in this global pandemic, our group and many groups have contributed more than crores of rupees. That is also their CSR. But CSR as a core term relates to the local development. Because you know, why there is also a difference here. Suppose here, you can ask me that why it is giving contribution to the CM fund or PMRF. It is called CSR. Because you know, as the name itself implies, what benefit you are getting, the global conglomerate. Like the Tatas, the Birlas, the Jindals, the other companies, Vedanta, they have their presence globally. They have their presence nationally. And besides, their locations in sites. So to contribute to globally for a global pandemic to PMRF is also called a CSR activities. But that is at given times. But CSR, as the core term is concerned, it always looks after this development of the peripheral villages where it operates.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I can add on this. Government has also fixed some amount of money.
2%,
that is 2% of the total from the total profit that is accumulated in 3 years of profit. Supposed to be this year we got more profit. Last year we have somehow little profit. That last to last year we got more and more profit than this year. So yes. This 3 year profit 2% will be. Each year 2% will take and divided into 3 will be taken that particular fund to this year budget for CSR. So this money can be distributed or disbursed in the form of periphery development as well as there are you can see Tata Rasta Karichanti, you can see jo anek organization nijo nijara gachha lagochan side re ta dhere name plate lagochanti. How they are writing, because these are also CSR funds. Kichi kichi nalakup kholuthwe ko gaare particularly kichi gote youth center khola aichi. Those monies are from CSR fund. So you can ask, anga pakare ette paisa aichi? No. Government has already fixed that this much of amount you have to compulsorily do on behalf of the people where you have set up your business or your industry. So, sir, the next class ko etal hobo sir eta detail karibi kahibe.
Yes.
So, hope we should complete today's class. We have enough questions, and I hope everyone got their answers. And there is a link provided by Sumita Marana madam, and to give the feedback of today's class. I hope everyone will be joined and give the feedback. And lastly, I would like to thank all my learners at here. And immense thankful to Bibhudatta sir to giving us time to the university and in this situation where we can all come with a virtual connection. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I would like to thank my co-colleague Rakesh Das to be here with me, as well as my technical team, without whom we cannot able to succeed the connectivity of whole process of this session. Thank you, Sumita ma'am, and Abhinandan. So let us stop here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Someone is asking where I can have the recorded video. I hope after some days we will upload all this recorded video.